Hi, I'm Karen. On behalf of the workshop facilitation team, I'm thrilled to be welcoming you to the Creative Computing Online Workshop. Before I dive into the big ideas of week one and of the workshop overall, I'm assuming that you've seen the preview video for the workshop and that you've read the frequently asked questions page. If you haven't, that's totally fine, but those are both sources of valuable information about the workshop, so you can check those out at your leisure. In this week's overview video, there are three themes that I wanted to cover. One, this is not a course. Two, structure isn't always bad, and it isn't always good. And three, community is awesome. Let's dive in. As I was thinking about how to best describe what I hope this learning experience will be like for you, I was reminded of a piece by the artist René Magritte, which I'm sure many of you have seen. It's a picture of a pipe with the text, "This is not a pipe." I can imagine some of you having a similar feeling arriving at the Creative Computing site. I'm telling you, it's not a course. You're looking at the site and thinking, what do you mean this is not a course? Well, I wanted to share with you that the facilitation team isn't thinking about it as a course and not really as a training. And these are words that I kind of shy away from. And it's partly due to something I read several years ago by Seymour Papert. In his 1993 book, The Children's Machine, Rethinking School in the Age of the Computer. He wrote, "Although the name is not what is most important about this concept, it is curious that the phrase teacher training comes trippingly off the tongues of people who would be horrified at the suggestion that teachers are being trained to train children." Those words invoke particular expectations about the relationship between a learner and sets of ideas and experiences. And with creative computing, we wanted to disrupt some of those expectations. Creative computing isn't about delivery or filling you up with content. But what does that mean? What is it then? Well, it's intended to be an exploration in creating, so this is computational creation with Scratch, but also an exploration in connecting, building relationships with others in the workshop. It's also an exploration in supporting this type of exploration online. So some things are going to work with translating a face-to-face experience online. Some things aren't going to work. We're trying some new things out, and we're really glad that you're a part of it. But let's get more concrete. What does all of this mean for you week to week? Well, let me start by telling you a little bit about the overall organization. As you probably know, the workshop is 6 weeks long. The first 3 weeks, which we call foundations, are an opportunity to develop greater familiarity and fluency with the Scratch authoring environment and online community through a series of scaffolded or structured activities. It's meant to be a hands-on introduction to computational thinking concepts and computational thinking practices. If you're interested in learning more about the phrase computational thinking, and particularly computational thinking with Scratch, I've included some links to readings below. The final 3 weeks, which we call explorations, are an opportunity for you to define and pursue a self-directed project. This might be designing Scratch activities. It might be documenting your experiences of helping others learn Scratch, or maybe experimenting with advanced features in Scratch 2.0. It's a project that you can develop on your own or in collaboration with others. But in general, participate in the workshop as much or as little as you like. Create as much or as little as you like. Connect as much or as little as you like. We're just here to provide suggestions for interesting types of experiences, types of things to make, type of things to read, types of things to discuss, types of things to explore. Throughout the workshop, we'll be encouraging you to keep track of your learning in an electronic design notebook. You might use a Google Doc, you might use a Google presentation, and there's more information about how to possibly set up an electronic design notebook below. Many people have asked about certificates. If you're interested in receiving a certificate of participation from the Scratch Ed team, you'll need to have submitted your design notebook 6 times, basically once a week. And you'll need to have done 6 peer reviews once a week before the course ends on Saturday, July 13th. Your certificate will contain a link to your design notebook, and your design notebook serves as a type of portfolio, as a type of performance assessment. But let's get even more concrete. Let's talk about the structure of the first 3 weeks, the ideas and activities that we'll be exploring actually this week, this first week. And we'll now transition to the second big theme. Structure isn't always bad, and it isn't always good. For the past several years, I've been really obsessed with the role of structure in learning experiences. That's what my dissertation was about, looking at the role of structure in supporting a learner's ability to define and pursue learning objectives. And I was using Scratch both in school and out of school as extended case studies. If you're interested in reading it, if you have time for 200 pages of light reading, I've added a link below. When you're designing learning experiences for others, I think structure is something you always need to be thinking about, because there are different types of structures and different contexts demand different structures. I hope that you'll think about the varying forms and degrees of structure, scaffolding, and support that we've designed into the workshop, and then use the workshop as an opportunity to reflect on the ways in which you use structure in supporting others' learning. This week, we're offering 5 different activities, from very structured to very unstructured, as a way of getting started with Scratch or going deeper with Scratch. And you're welcome to do as many or as few of them as you like. We've organized the week's activities list so that the big project of the week is at the top. So for people who already have some Scratch experience, you can just jump right in to create your About Me collage. If you're new, or if you want to get more practice, you can explore the other activities. The step-by-step project, the 10 blocks project, the studios activity, or the debug it challenges. The last theme that I want to touch on in this week's overview video is the role of community in supporting learning, which I've titled, Community is Awesome! We know that learning is not an exclusively individual process. We know that creativity is not an exclusively individual process. We can benefit enormously from our interactions with others. And we've certainly seen this with young learners in the Scratch online community since it launched in 2007. And I've posted some links to readings about this below. Building connections between members of the workshop is something that's really important to us, and we hope that it will be really important to you as well. This will happen through asynchronous interactions, through the Scratch online community, through peer review of design notebooks, through discussion forums. This will also happen through synchronous interactions. We'll be hosting live office hours twice a week, on Tuesday afternoon and Friday morning, Boston time. As a member of the facilitation team, I can tell you that my colleagues, who you can learn more about on the team page, are looking forward to working with you and to learning with you and from you. We also hope that you make wonderful connections to your creative computing colleagues. Again, we are thrilled that you're joining us for creative computing. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to let us know in the workshop forums. I hope that you have wonderful learning experiences over the next several weeks.